today's episode, Inside High School Sports, where we are again on the road here in Magnolia, Arkansas at Panther Arena. Got some special guests for you, so just check us out. We'll be back with our special guests in just a moment. To today's episode, I got my man here, Mr. Darnell Ford. It's glad to have you here on the show, man. He opened up this nice venue, and what's crazy about it, this is my first time ever seeing the Panther Arena this empty. Oh man, first time he actually get him chest on the floor. I don't know if this is one of his hot spots, his little short jumpers, or what it is, but it's good to have you here to share this moment with you. Mm-hmm. It's been a great journey, and the journey still will continue. We get ready to close chapter one with your son here, Darrian, before we get a chance to have him later on the show. Just tell me how this year his career has went here at Magnolia.
Man, it's been great. It's been great in terms of, like I say, from the start, man, we moved back, and when we got back, we was right in front of, matter of fact, right out in front of the arena. We set goals. We came, the goal was win 4 championships, but we ended up winning 3. And as you know, and everybody that really know, that's close to me, know number 3 is very special to me. And the 3 is not his number. The 3 stands for one God, one faith, one baptism. Because we know everything we're going to do to make it, it's got to be through God. But man, I have no complaints, man. And if we was to try to go back to the numbers, man, you know, last 3 years we hadn't lost for 1 game. And I said again, it hadn't been easy. It's been a lot of hard nights in here. Lights on now, but it used to get dark in here and we'd be working. So to say that, man, it's been a blessing, man. And I kind of have tears, man, to see him leave.
And you know, not just you, we're talking about actually the whole Panther Nation, the whole city, the whole Columbia. We're going to go the whole Columbia County, not just Columbia County. You got Union County, Washington County. Everybody get a chance to come see this young man play.
Yeah.
I never forget it. And I'll talk to him about it when I get him on the show. I was sitting probably right there in the section around some Panther fans. Mm-hmm. And I just enjoy watching sports. I don't care if I have opportunity. I usually come down here and try to check it out. So I'm sitting on row number 2, and I got opportunity. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, who is that kid number 20? Where is he playing college ball at next year?
Yeah.
They looked at me crazy. They all got upset. They mad. I'm like, I'm sorry, did I say something wrong? I said, where is this kid going to play college ball at next year? Mm-hmm. They said, nowhere. I said, man, these guys gotta be crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't nobody recruiting this kid. Mm-hmm. And he this good. They said, man, he just a freshman. I said, do what? And I'm like, I left here, I got on the phone, I said, told some of my guys that I work with, I said, man, y'all gotta see this kid.
Yeah.
I said, he a 9th grade. I said, right now, he's already good enough. He plays about like a junior or senior already. And that's what he brought to the game. Very quiet, very humble. And that's one thing I like about it. You know, real quiet kid. And I see a lot of stuff. Everybody look at the sports realm of it, the academic realm of it, but I see him participating in church on a regular basis. Not just every now and then, but regular basis.
Oh, yes. That's a must. You know, in everything we do, we put God first. In every interview we do, we all give God all the glory. And going to church. And then the thing about it, it's the impact. If you were to ask me right now, you say, well, how many points he scored in his first game? I couldn't tell you, and I'm serious. But if you ask me the impact that he put on young kids' lives, not just young kids, adults, older people, it was the impact. And I think before I talk to you, we was going through something his 9th grade year. We had like maybe 5 killings right close to here in this area. And man, me and him were thinking when we be in here working out, we're like, what could we do, man, to pull the community back together? And man, we prayed to God. And God did it, man. I mean, man, we would have church buses coming in. I mean, elders, people that never come to the game. And we just wanted to get our community back together. And when you think about it, and I love to say this, man, it's not about Derrian. this impact is about, God gave him this platform, and I told him at seven, eight years old, God gave you this platform for you to share his word, and he's gonna elevate you so all men can see. So I just have to say, man, we give all the glory to God. We love all the fans, coaches. It hasn't been easy. And we, you know, when he gets to go to the next journey, you know, he don't mind coming in, not being talked about, but he gonna make an impact.
And that's what it's all about, making an impact. Mm-hmm. And when you're saying just the killings that was going on, mm-hmm. people don't understand what sports can do.
That's right.
If you use it in the right positive way and let God work in that thing.
Working.
A lot of people don't allow, they say sports is just to get you to the next level, make a lot of money, buy the cars and fans at home and get your name in the newspaper, win trophies and the championships. But everything God put in plan or give us opportunity to do is for his purpose.
That's right.
And Darrian took it for his purpose and got a chance to brought the whole community together. And I'm talking about, it's not, and I'm just gonna say this, I have went to venues, and I go to a lot of different sports areas where you see a whole lot of African-Americans playing the sport, and you see a lot of Caucasians in the arena.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see that here at Panther Arena.
We mix.
And we all are, y'all mixed in, everybody giving each other high five, they shouting, they happy. And that's the thing, I wish we could, you know, people can see that.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about what color we are, not about color of our skin, it's about us. Cheer these kids on, promote them to the next level, and bring positivity to our community as well as our young men.
Mm-hmm. And to add to that, Antonio, I taught him how to be so respectable. It doesn't matter about color, race, it doesn't at all. If you're talking to someone, I taught him it's either yes sir, no sir, yes ma'am, no ma'am. If you walking in a door and you see an elderly lady coming, you know the rule, hold the door for her. If they say thank you, it's okay. If they don't, you know, it's okay. Just be so respectable. Be an impact that someone look out like you did, like you said. It's something special about this young man. And I instill that in all my kids, you know. I try to instill them to be very professional, always be professional. First of all, you represent God. Second of all, you represent me. And everybody might know me. So, hey, if it comes back negative, a negative results in a negative. So, you know, we got ways of fixing that. We can fix that.
Hey, tell him, I don't care how many threes you can shoot. I'm still there and I can still handle my beat with that.
The belt come off every night. Man, I can say I never had to, you know, like that. Man, I think I went to his school, he first grade. Never forget it. Walked around, he was sitting on the floor. He looked at me and saw me. I said, okay. But he didn't do nothing. He was just with the wrong crowd. But If I go rob a bank and you with me, you just as gifted as I am. And he had to learn that in the first grade. I'd never forget it. Now, the look on his eyes when I saw him, but I knew then, man. But he was a special kid. Everybody, you know, he loves everybody. And Antonio, let me say this. I never heard him say a down word on another player. And I look, and I'm gonna tell you, he didn't get that from me. Never. The only tech he ever had, he hung on the rim. And the referee gave him a tick. Before he was talking to a referee, I never seen him throw a ball. He handed it to the referee, yes sir, or he'd give him a thumbs up. And I got to truly say, I can't take none of the credit. Mom can't. We have to give it to God, man. God humbled that young man. He said, I'm going to use you, and I'm going to use you right. And I give all glory to God.
And you know, and the thing about it, you know, some people have to go through a whole lot to get that humbleness.
Yeah.
He didn't have to do that. He saw early, you know, hanging with the wrong crowd. Just think about, you know, we think daddy being hard, daddy won't let us go and hang with certain people.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't look at that like, I've been there. I've done that. Yeah. I know what destruction will lead you to if you get with the wrong people.
Mm-hmm.
It's always like guilty by association, some of the worst
stuff. Right.
Especially when other people around you know there's something great about you.
That's right.
You have those in the corner with you. Really, say they're in your corner, but at the same time, they're really bringing you down and try to lead you in the right wrong path.
Mm-hmm.
And It's special. And I have a lot of contact with a lot of different kids.
Mm-hmm.
And not knocking none of my guys, none of my boys, all of them are special to me.
Mm-hmm.
But he's the second kid that I always told somebody parent, it's something special about him because he was different.
Thank you.
Matter of fact, right now he played for the New York Yankees.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's amazing about Jacobus Davis. I know you know Jonathan Davis.
Yeah.
And it was always something special about that kid. He never fussed, he never talked. He had a positive attitude. He served. He served God on a daily basis.
Oh, yeah.
He was humble. Never heard him talk down. He was always the one that's the mediator in everything, every problem situation. And he was game time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one thing about it. And people like that, they don't know how great attitude, great characteristics will take you further than any time you can shoot a three-pointer, or dunk a basketball, or assist, steal, block, or whatever you may do. How great, you know, your character, your attitude, how far it'll take you.
That's right. That's right. And I can tell you today, and tell you, I tried the other way. I was the big mile, the noise talker, hang out, you know, never drink, never smoke, anything like that. But I tried it, and I said to myself, I'm going to save you some steps through the mud. And I told him, it never worked because I never had God in it. But I said, well, here, we're going to put God first, and everything fell in place, man. We're going to continue to keep God. You know, I'm very competitive now. So you might hear me, you know, I might shoot a text out here and there when I think somebody's slick talking. But in the end, man, it's all fun, you know. I've met some of my best friends playing on this court, but we was fighting on the court, but we best friends to this day.
Well, this is what we're going to do. We're going to take a break. Okay. We're going to come back. Okay. And we're going to talk a little bit about your career. You're going to let us fill in about you. Because, you know, it's more than just being the coach and the trainer. That's it's a little bit more behind the scenes as well, where he got some of his talents and ability from as well. Yeah. Well, we'll be take a break and we'll be back briefly with Inside High School Sports. Inside High School Sports. Got Darnell Ford here. Got a chance to talk to you a little bit about the community and about son Derrian that we'll bring on the set a little bit later. You athlete yourself. You know, I know you kind of hide it a little bit. We can't, this, you know, it's something that you instilled in him as well. For you to be able to get out here and train him and work with it and get in shape. I see what I don't call it the weight room, I call it the laboratory.
That's it.
And that's just like this place right here. Yeah. When it's empty, it's a laboratory.
Mm-hmm.
When it's full, it's an arena.
Mm-hmm.
But you pretty good at on the hardwood yourself.
Yeah, hey, I put in a lot of work, man. I love the game of basketball. I just went about it the wrong. I had my priorities mixed up. I had basketball, then God, when it should have been God, then basketball. I had a chance to go real far. I really don't talk about it much because if I did, a lot of people might not believe me, you know what I'm saying? But God knows. So what I do, man, I'm competitive in whatever I do. And he picked up on it. At the age of 6 years old, I started him. I would lift weight, I'll power lift him. And I take him everywhere I go, man. He was my motivation. I have 400 pounds on me. And if I just hear him say, push it, daddy, I can get it. And I instill the same thing in him as well as all of my kids, man. We competitive, man. It doesn't matter, marble, dominoes, it don't matter, horseshoe. And that's what life is, man. And I teach him, if you can win in this and don't quit, you can win in life, man. Because, you know, being a mentor here, I tell a lot of kids now, life is tough. And they always say, oh, I'll be glad I get out of school. Matter of fact, I was talking to one last night. I said, how's that life going? He said, Mr. Ford, you said it. And so, you know, we have to share. We have to share, man, and I have my passion just how I was on the basketball court. I want to be the best mentor. I want to be one of the best speakers at the church. You know, whatever I do, I want to be the best at it.
And that's what people don't understand. And I have the opportunity to talking to people and teaching in classes, and, you know, district-wide and statewide as well. And I always tell them, everybody, it sounds so negative to some people, until you grow up and mm-hmm. you hit that wall.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I tell them, everybody here is not going to make it.
That's right. That's right.
You know, some people just here just because their mama and them made them come. Mm-hmm. Everybody really is not going to make it. And I just break it down. It's going to be some stuff that you're going to get yourself into. You're going to surround yourself with some people mm-hmm. that's outside, especially when you're going to college.
That's right.
You know, you don't have just Magnolia.
That's
you don't
right.
have just Waldo.
That's right.
You know, you don't
that's
have just right. Stevens and McNeil. You have different people, different states that have some different ulterior motives, mm-hmm. and they used to the slick game.
Mm-hmm.
We
mm-hmm.
country.
That's right. That's right.
We
that's
country. Right. We country boys. So we not up to date with all the stuff the way they do it. And at the end of the day, some of them dodged me.
That's right.
And some of them said, well, you said it. Mm-hmm. You know, no knock to you. I'm not going to say I said so. I know. Been there, done that.
Yeah.
And we try to hedge it out before you get to that point.
That's right.
But some of them, you just have to let them bump their head against the wall. And I hate it.
Totally.
You know, especially when you love them.
That's right.
And you care about somebody and you can see potential, mm-hmm. but they don't see the potential in themselves. And that's all about getting around some positive people and just learning it and taking heed to it. You know, fall and get back up. You know, now you're miserable and you know, we look at the suicide rate.
That's right. That's right.
It's like mind boggling. Like, I cannot believe this child is thinking about killing themselves. You know, you have more than our grandparents and our great grandparents ever had. But then I think we want to flip side and say we give them too much.
That's right.
We don't give them God. We don't give them love. We don't show them compassion. We don't show them that this world is a competitive world.
That's right.
You know, from flipping burgers to McDonald's to being a doctor or a judge on the Supreme Court.
That's right.
This is a competitive world because you had to compete against somebody to be able to get in med school,
the
job interview. It's just a competitive world. And if you're not willing to compete,
that's right.
It's about time you lay down and die. And that's just the bottom line.
That's right. That's right.
And you know, it's so harsh being said that way, but that's life.
It's true. You said it. It's life. And I implemented it in my kids. And when I'm not talking about all my biological, I'm talking about the kids in school. I'm not ashamed to share God with them. Because in the end, let me tell you something. Everything you named off a while ago, you named off a whole lot of things. I've taught my kids, they only temporary. But God's love, it's forever. Cars, temporary. Money, temporary. This basketball, temporary. Anything you can name, houses, temporary, man. But the love of God is forever. So, you know, I teach it to all the kids, not just my biological kids. I mean, I tell them all the time, man. I invite them to church or some come. Like you say, some come, some don't. But it's just my competitiveness. And I told God the same way I was in the world, when I was in the world, I want to be that good in church. Yeah, and I ain't shame. I wouldn't shame me.
Hey, don't need to be that.
Why shame God?
Well, they say you drive it for the devil. Hey, let me drive it for God.
Let's do it, man.
And that's way. That's a great path. I wish, you know, just more people just can really just listen and sit down and listen and take heed to what you're saying.
Yeah.
And you know, and at times it used to burn me out. Like I just bump my head against the wall. You know, Dad and them say, the more I talk, the dumber I get. But you know what?
Yeah.
It's one thing about it. On down the road, they might never tell you that they understand now.
Yeah.
But they understand. Well, they say understand by and by.
By and by. That's the song. Plant that seed, and then sometime you come back, Antonio, it done grew. You know, somebody came by and watered it. Meaning just because you started it, don't mean God wanted you to finish it. See what I'm saying? So what we do, man, we have to plant it. We have to be good at it, you know. Talk to them. Don't give up on them. When I lose one, it's just like compare, just like playing a game. I don't want to lose a kid.
Yeah.
Do we lose them? Yes, we do.
Yeah.
But we're going to give it our best.
Yeah. And we both have done the same thing.
Oh,
it's some kids that we let, you know, and we still talk to this day, even when they were in 5th and 6th grade. Me and the guy talk, like, we see it. We like, man, we let that kid fall by the wayside. Mm-hmm. And we take it so personal that we upset with ourselves because we should have put more into that kid instead of putting more into another kid.
Yes.
But we live and we learn. We learn from the mistake as well.
Yes.
And we was like, we did not help that kid reach his full potential.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We did not help him, and you know, and just the way it is, it's only one of us.
Yeah.
And we have millions of people that we have impacted, and that has been the great, and it's good to hear that you're out here giving back to other kids, you know, and they can see the result. It makes your job a little bit easier because they see where they see.
Boy, don't you know, hey. Cause like, this is what I get all the time. Ain't you Darren Ford, Dad? I said, yeah. And let me tell you what I used to tell Dave. And it works, Antonio. It works, man, because he's a walking example, you know. And what you see is what you get. What you see here, you get the same thing at home, you know. He's a great person. Actually, I always say this. After God, he's probably my best friend, man. I could talk to him about it when I want to, you know, talk to him about anything. And he's taught me this here, man. Dad, we don't have to comment on everything somebody says. Now, I'm 53. He just turned 18. he taught me that, man, and I'm getting better at it, man. Yeah. Now every now and then,
it's only the day. It was a bad phrase.
It's hard.
Especially when you know. Me sitting in the stand, and we hear everything. I'm mic'd up most of the time, and you can hear the booze by some of the people that you know overrated and mm-hmm. this and that. Mm-hmm. And you like, okay. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, why come in? Because you see what's coming to see you.
Proof in the pudding.
You know, you ain't burning no gas driving all over the country trying to get recruited.
Yeah.
Hey, you, wherever you want to sign your name on the line at, and it's paid for. It's paid for.
27 D1 offers.
It was amazing. If he didn't get a D1 offer in basketball, he got an academic scholarship as well.
Just as well, because he's a 4.0 student.
It does not get any bigger than what he's putting out. He's not just out here playing basketball. Mm-hmm. He's guaranteed. The coach, one thing about the next level, I always tell people, I say, you see all these 5-star, 4-star, 5-star, 3-star going to play.
Yeah.
What are they going to do when they get there in the classroom?
That's right.
You know, a lot of them guys, the one thing about him, you know he's going to get in the classroom. So,
that's right.
Hey, I'm going to invest in him. And that's what make coaches invest in them guys. Yes. Like, he's going to be here. I'm not have to worry about him being on academic probation. Mm-hmm. When I get ready to go out there, you know, he's going to do the right thing, even when we're not here. And that's the big plus with having somebody like Derrian on your team and being recruited. And he was recruited heavily.
Heavily.
You know I got to do it.
All right.
And I'm going to have to be honest. I was excited when I see him with that purple and gold. I was so excited. I said, we go get him because his daddy from Louisiana. They from Louisiana, you know. I said he's going, and I was just everybody. I was just happy. I posted it. I'm sharing it and everything. I'm excited. I said yes sir. But then. So he flipped it to Arkansas, and I was in my feelings. I ain't gonna play. I'm not gonna hold. I was in my feelings. All but right. The thing about it, the best thing about it is I'm gonna support 100%. At the end of the day, it's not about where you go to school.
That's right.
It's what you bring to the table, getting that degree.
That's
you know, making your living where you're happy at. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. not knocking it. Mm-hmm. You know, I still, you know, who knows? It's God's plan.
That's
I'm pretty sure he'll have a great career. Awesome. Wherever he goes,
we praying.
It does not matter. Mm-hmm. And one thing I did like about it, it's some schools offered him that really went D1, and he still posted them. And I'm like, it was because a lot of schools wanted to go after him, and they was kind of afraid. No, he did not turn anybody down. He all supported from SAU to UAPB.
Yes.
And that's the great thing about him. He's never burned your bridges.
That's right.
And the recruiting thing, you never know what happened. You might have to go back and cross that bridge.
Right.
Things happen like that. Injuries are where they kind of give up on you.
Yeah.
And that's what my brother was the same way. I told him, I said, don't burn your bridges.
That's right.
He went to a school that they really weren't treating him right. I said, did you turn them down? Nope, I just didn't go there. End up coming back down to SAU, they put him on scholarship like that. Mm-hmm. I said, that's because you didn't burn your bridges.
Yeah.
And it's all about take everything to heart, thank them, appreciate them, that you took the time out to even write me a letter and took a chance on me.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, that's hard taking a chance on somebody like that, knowing he top of the line, Ivy League, D1, SEC, ACC, Big 10, Big 12, they was here.
Mm-hmm.
And some people didn't have to know how to get the Magnolia. I said, this thousand of the cow manure, but hey, you got a guy that's in the lab that's working and is going to make a big impact on the community,
mm-hmm.
His teammates as well. And it's been a pleasure talking with you.
Oh, yeah.
I tell
pleasure
you.
Pleasure being here, man.
I'm telling you. And it ain't but one thing that somebody can make me do, and we'll talk, you'll find it out a little bit later. It's a little bit different for me. And I'll take the talk, and I'm going to let him talk. I'm not going to respond to everything. I'm going to take his word. I'm not going to respond to everything they say when it's be posted. But it's been a joy. And I want to continue following him. Right now, I got a chance to see him for free.
Yeah.
But hopefully, you know, when the tickets cost me $200, $300, $400, $500, $1,000 seat, hey, it is what it is. And it just will be here, hometown favorite.
Yeah.
We're going to say all four corners. And it's been a pleasure talking to you, Mr.
Yes.
Ford.
Thank you.
I tell you, didn't turn me down. I was excited. We've been excited all week when I got a chance to inbox you. I ain't scared to tell nobody nothing. I'm competitive.
All the, and me and you just alike.
I said he could tell me yay or nay. If he say no, I'll understand.
Nah.
But it's good. We'll be talking more and more as we go by. I get with you on some mentoring stuff too.
Okay.
You know, we'll talk about that on the serious note.
Mm-hmm.
It's today's show, Inside High School Sports with Mr. Darnell Ford. Well, welcome to today's Inside High School Sports, where we here on the road here in Columbia County. Look like we're in an empty Panther Arena, where we're gonna call it the lab for none other than a special guest I have here, Derrian Ford. We'll get a chance to talk with him about his high school career as well as the next level. We'll take a break and bring you back more Derrian Ford here after these messages.
Hey young world, the world is yours.
Hey young world, the world is yours.
Young world,
the world is yours.
Young world.
Welcome back to Inside High School Sports, where I got the main man, Mr. Panther. Former be a, after a while, in a few more months, will be a official Razorback. You're already a Razorback signee, but you're getting ready to finish up here, finish a great career here for the Magnolia Panthers. And it's good to have you on the show, Derrian Ford.
Glad to be here.
Glad to be. And I tell you, it's been an honor and a pleasure to be able to watch you play, grow, master the game of basketball, coach the game of basketball, you know, defense, offensive end of the floor. And I'm going to take you all the way back to the first game against El Dorado. I got a chance to come here in the arena to actually watch it. I'm just riding, and I said, I'm going to go down here and watch a little basketball El Dorado was playing. And somebody popped out to me. And I'm watching this kid, number 20, he's balling. I'm like, man, that kid good. And I lean over, and I think it was maybe Garland dad was sitting right there on the front row. And I said, where's that kid playing basketball in this year? They looked at me. I said, where that kid playing basketball? They said, nowhere. I said, man, what's wrong with him? I said, is his grades bad or is it, but they don't know no better. So I'm like, I'm finna send some emails out or something. I'm not even got a connection like this. But I'm like, man, somebody got to come get this kid. SAU somebody. They turned around and said, he just a freshman. I said, man, are you serious? And that's what you brought to the table. This your freshman year. Kind of walk me through a little bit of your freshman. I know it's a few years ago and been a little while. We went through a pandemic and all that. Tell me a little bit about your freshman year.
My freshman year came in. Coach Long was my first coach, my first high school coach. He told me things that he expected from me, and he told me he just wanted me to come in and play my role. And so when he told me that, I already knew what he expected. So now he gave me the answer to what I need. This is what he expected me. Let me show him I could do a little bit more. And so I came in, played, got the jitters out of me in my first game. And it went on from there, and the rest is history. Going to the state championship, you know, we battled every day at practice. I got to play against great competition, a lot of seniors that I took a piece of every one of their game. And, you know, just from the rebounding to running the lane to taking charges, you know, you can just learn so much from different people on the court. And it was just a great experience, you know, just the fun time that you won't get to see your sophomore year, your junior year, your senior year again, because once the freshman year is over, that's it. So I tried to make the best of it, and I had a great time learning things that Coach Long wanted me to do and Coach Miller wanted me to do. It was just different situations that helped me adapt to Coach Lindsay and being able to adapt to the situation that he brought to me.
So when you come out and the coach said he wants you to play your role, and it's almost hard for a coach to come out and say, as a freshman on a varsity, you know, very few freshmen can play on that level because of the game speed, the physicality changes. Very quick, people don't understand from a ninth grade to a 10th grade how stronger you get, how much the game is, you know, seconds quicker. And he asked you to play your role, and you come out and you dominate.
I tried to do a little something. You know, he wanted me to play point guard role, just get people involved and get 5-6 rebounds, average about 14 points a game. You know, he just wanted a good season. We wanted a good season, and I felt that we could do more. And after a certain while, we all started believing in each other that we could actually win state championship. And there it was. We were actually in High Springs my freshman year, and we won.
So you went 24-5. your freshman year. Got a chance. Only one team that there's only one team in the conference that ever beat you your whole career. That was, you know, Monticello. I know that's a team you'll never forget. Great legendary coach Darnell, well coached. He had some great ball players as well. Had Scottie Pippen nephew at the time. So he was loaded. You all was loaded. I think they beat you one time here, and then they beat you in the regionals as well. I watched that. That was a nail biter on both ways, and it could have went either way. And that's the thing about it as a freshman. And not only did you win a state championship, what else happened after you won the state championship?
I got the MVP.
MVP. That was our way to come out. Then, you know, ninth grade, he asked you just to come in, play your role. Then you bounce back. You become MVP at the end of the season as a freshman. And then, you know, it's our history. Now it's like, man, this kid is like the real deal. So come down. T-grade year, everything comes natural now. It's a little bit easier. You get a little bit bigger. Now you running things.
Yes, well, you know, coming in, you know, Coach Long, he ended up being the athletic director. So now we have a new coach, Coach Lindsay, and he came in. He knew the situation he was coming into. We just came off a state championship run, but he came in with a mindset that he wanted to keep that going, and he knew that we were all hard workers because he had just saw us at the state tournament here. And then he came to watch us at the finals. So he saw what we could do, and he saw what we were capable of. And when we came in, we came prepared to work, just like we didn't win the state championship. We wanted to win another one. We wanted to keep that going. And you know, everybody bought into it, and we all just got along with each other.
So now we go to sophomore year. Another great season, 26-0, state championship. That was the lights really came on. You know, from freshman to sophomore year, now you're like, man, this is going to be something good. Now, the whole arena going from half full to being packed out.
Every game.
And so, how did that make you feel when you seeing the arena just packed out? You know, you're the slim, and the only thing they used to pack out is football games. Now, the main thing down here, we became a basketball school.
Basketball. You want to just keep it going. You know, you want more people. Seeing it, the first sophomore game, you want to just keep bringing people in, bring the community back together, let them know that there's still talent down here, there's still something for them to look forward to during when they don't have to work or when they just want something to do or just something to watch. So you just want to keep that going. Just like when you're on top of the mountain, you want to stay on top of the mountain. You don't want to come down. You want to just keep building, building, and building.
Yeah, and then we, you know, that next season we kind of went, I think COVID started hitting. And that was a tour for everybody. It was just up in the air. And that year you won a state championship the second year as a junior year. I think that is the one when it was kind of, y'all split championship. Really, it really didn't matter because
it was sophomore year
that I think COVID.
COVID came.
And right when it was time to play the game, just about a few weeks before, it kind of shut everything down.
Yes, after that game against Brooklyn, my sophomore year, COVID started kicking in right before we played our state championship, and we couldn't play it. And so now we're co-champions. Now it just started building. So we find out we're not being able to play the sophomore championship game, and now time's rolling by. COVID just getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Everybody's talking about it. So now we got to go into my junior year and dealing with COVID. It was different. You know, you had the benches were separated. People on this side on the court, some people on this side. You have to wear your mask when you play sometimes. It was just a different thing, you know, the crowd was different, atmosphere was different. So it's just stuff that we had to adapt to, and I'm happy that we were able to do that because it helped us in the long run having to adapt to situations for when we got to play my senior year. So it was just everything. I think God had it lined out for a purpose.
So when we think about being co-champion, and I know you like, you competitive, you're real competitive. How did it make you feel being a co-champion to somebody when you know you didn't really want, when you didn't play the game?
Well, it's better than nothing. I take the state championship. You know, that mean it could have went either way. So if they feel that we could have won, we could have won. If they feel they could have won, they could have won. But we're both champions, so they can't take that away from us.
So guess what happened your senior year? Who did you spot up with?
We spot up with the same people that won my junior year. So we spot up at home. So we hadn't lost a home game in a long time.
It's been a long time.
It's been a long time. And to play them here at home, it was a great experience. You know, the crowd was hyped. It was just something that you probably wouldn't get to see again, another atmosphere like that and another state tournament like that. It was just something you'll never forget. So it was just great.
It was moments where in the games where you see people lined up outside like they was camping out. Yes. And I tell you, you brought, it was just so much to it that you brought together. And it was just, it was a lot there, you know. And we'll take a break. We're gonna come back with you talking about community change and how you're impacting and changing other people's mind as well.
Hey, young world is yours.
Welcome back to High School Sports, where I got the main man himself, Darrian Ford, the Razorback signee, not commit, because you're on another level. You're already on sign, seal, and deliver, going to the hill. A moment ago, we were talking about how the arena packed out and the impact that you brought to the community. You and your teammates, and that's the thing about it, you never left anybody out. You got everybody involved. Everybody got their points. You know, it was spurts in the moment where you say, I'm just going to be a facilitator. I'm going to play on the defensive end. I'll get the other guys, let them shoot the three ball. I'll let Walker shoot. I'll move it around to the inside of the game. And that's the thing about you. You're a team player, community impact. How did that all form to, you know, bringing a large community that you, some people, they're like, how do you know they stayed in Columbia County? How you packed out and impact a lot of people's lives?
I feel that, you know, not just me, but we all impacted everybody's lives. You know, little kids, some of these kids, they're probably never get to see a game like this again. So, you know, if I'm hurt or my knee's sore, my ankle's sore, I'm not gonna not play, because this could be a kid first time being able to see me play, and he come to a game, he not seeing me play, now he just spent all his money for nothing. His $5 is gone, it's wasted. And so I don't ever wanna disappoint a kid, and I'm sure my teammates, they don't ever wanna disappoint a kid. They try to play as much as they can, play as hard as they can, and give the people a show, but just have fun.
Well, you impacted, you done a lot, you give the people what they want. I'm gonna tell you. And you're the only person. Now you got me stuttering over here. You're the only person can make me do this. You're the only person. It ain't been but one. You know, I have big arguments. I know your dad probably see it on Facebook. If you saw what I put on Facebook the other day when they played Duke, you probably wouldn't even be sitting here talking with me. But I'm gonna step out. And I'm gonna let you sit there and talk to the camera and just talk about the different things and about your career goals. And I'll be back.
Something else, man.
He think he about to do something.
Yeah. You know, if this is something he don't do, actually, he can't stand what he about to do.
He can't stand it.
But
I must,
today, he love it.
It must be something special.
He love it today, man.
It must be something special. Oh, man.
You're the only one can make me do this.
Hey, I like that shirt. That's the shirt that you're supposed to always wear. Right,
hey, you know, and this, you know, and I haven't worn a Razorback shirt since 2000 and I think my brother was being recruited by the Razorbacks, and that's been 2006, 2007. A long time.
That's a long time.
You know, I use these. I tell them I won't even change all in these shirts. But guess what?
For me, you're gonna do it.
For the impact and what you do, what you've done for the community, as well as just, you know, being able to take the time out, busy schedule. Everybody not gonna be able to chance to get to sit down and talk with you like me and you one on one. Because otherwise, it's going to cost them. It's going to cost them. That's one thing about it. I always try to get them while they're young and fresh and everything. But guess what? You have instilled positivity through the coaching staff, through your players, through the whole community. Got a chance to talk with your dad. How big and important was that for you to bring Columbia County as a whole back together?
It was very important. You know, my seventh grade year, I played at Magnolia for the eighth and ninth grade when I was in seventh grade, but I only went to junior high my seventh grade year for one semester. Then I moved to Texas. Ended up moving to Texas. I was sad. I tried to find any little positive thing, somebody to adopt me. I did not want to leave. But you know, I went out there for better,
for better traveling support because I had to travel a lot from Magnolia to Texas because I play AAU in Texas. So there was a lot of sacrifice my mom and them had to make and then have to go to work the next day. So we thought moving out there would be better. So he wouldn't have to travel as far. And then she got to spend time with her family. But after AAU season was over with in Texas, I told my mom and dad I'm ready to go back home. And so they were happy. They were ready to come back home. And when we came back, first place we came to was the Panther Ring. Me and my dad, we came, just me and him. We stood in front of it. We had our hands up. And then we got on our knees. And I told him I wanted to bring state championship back here. And he said he was willing to work with me and we were going to work hard and make that come true. So it was just a special moment. That's the only thing that motivated me. That was my purpose. My purpose just changed throughout the season, but I always had a purpose. That was to win state championship.
And you done just that, three of them. And, you know, it's hard to even get to a championship game, but you had the opportunity to win three of them. Three-time real deal MVP, three-time state champion, two-time Gatorade Arkansas Player of the Year, over 2,000 points total career. I mean, all-star, all-conference, all-state, next level. I mean, and you know, inducted into the Hall of Fame, one of the Hall of Fames. You hadn't even got the High School Hall of Fame yet. That's coming, you know, because what you have done, you're going to have College Hall of Fame because I know you'll do great things there. And then you got the NBA Hall of Fame. I mean, you got so much that you still, people's like, man, he received so much and already as a young man. What has your parents and your dad have instilled in you what it takes to get to this point in your life so far?
I think the most thing, keeping God first and just staying disciplined. And they always tell me, do what they say, not what they do. Because, you know, sometimes things can happen as far as a parent. You know, parents, they have so much more pressure on them than the kids would think they do. And I see, like, my dad used to talk about him commenting on posts or seeing somebody talk about him. You know, that's hard for a parent. And I got to realize that's hard for a parent to see somebody talk about their kid. And sometimes you gotta give them a little leeway. Like, I know dad, I know it hurt you wanna come, I know mommy wanna come in on this, but you can't do that. But seeing them talk about their kid is,
yeah.
Any parent wanna take up for their, don't nobody wanna see nobody hurt their baby.
Yeah.
So it's just, you know, you just gotta deal with all the stuff that come your way. I think I'm pretty good at it. I try to stay humble, you know, not try to get big headed. Try to tell every teacher, I don't want them to treat me no other kind of way, no better than anybody else. I'm just like a normal student when I get off the court. When I get on the court, it's different for me. I feel that, you know, I'm a different person on the court, but off the court, I just want to be a normal person, you know. I want to hang out with my family, spend time, watch movies. Just different things, but just being disciplined is one thing I try to stay, and I just try to find a lot of positives. And one thing I saw, a man told me, I was in a choir rehearsal, and he said he would ask his son, what was the best part of your day? He never asked, how was your day? Because, you know, you could have a bad day. But if you think about what's the best part, your mind automatically go to something positive. It don't think about no negative. So I just try to stay positive. I've been trying to stay more positive throughout my senior year, and I feel that it's helping me.
And it shows. I mean, like you said, let me handle my work. Let me, you know, treat me just like it. And it's, I'm gonna be honest with you. In your shoes, the platform you're on, the stage you're on, and the thing about it, you didn't ask for all this. You just prayed about it. God answered your prayers. He gave it to you, use it in a positive way. And that's why I tell some things, success is so crazy. God blessing is so crazy because, you know, at the end of the day, you just asked for a championship. Yeah. And he gave you championships. Yeah. You know, he said, when he said, ask, and it shall be given unto you. You know, and the thing about what you have done, you put God at the head of everything. And one thing about it, when you say, hey, God, I need that three-pointer to be the clutch, hey, he gonna guide that thing in there. And that's the thing about it. We don't understand when we put God in our life, how he could guide and lead us. Not saying that we're not gonna mess up because we're human. Not saying we're not gonna turn the basketball over because we do. Not saying we're gonna slip down or get sick or anything, because we do.
It's gonna be good. It could be some bad things, you know? You just gotta take good with the bad, though.
And it's gonna be some games where you're like, man, I can't believe I just, I've seen you. You know, you're like, I, air ball a free throw and everybody going crazy. Like, but you, it is no, what it is.
That
and you
was
human.
Funny story tonight.
Yeah,
that
I mean,
was funny story tonight. Actually, we went to the house after the game, and we got to watch the NBA and we watched LeBron James the same night. And LeBron shot a free throw, he airballed. And then my dad said, see, ain't nobody perfect. Everybody human. So seeing LeBron airball a free throw, that made me feel better, because that's LeBron. That's LeBron. LeBron airballed a free throw. So seeing that made me feel better about myself. And as I said, if I airball another, I say LeBron airballed a free throw.
He get paid
all the time. He will pay. So that's a lot of positive, just trying to find positive.
And see, that's how God works, because, you know, like, you could easily got down on yourself, because they not saying, not daring you forward.
Yeah.
But, like, at the end of the day, you say you just like every other young man. You have to put on your trunk just like they do. You have to put on your jersey top. You have to run up and down the floor. You have to get in shape. You have to – it's nothing comes easy. If it comes easy, it's not going to last. And one thing about it, you have put in a lot of work to what you have been doing. And that has been the big upside and plus of everything. Putting God first, putting in the work, going to the laboratory. You know, even right here, like this is a laboratory. But when the stands are full, it's basketball, it's game time, it's the arena, and all the lab, everything I came from the lab, I'm taking it to the game, to the game. And you does just that. Now, get ready to go to the next level on the hill. They call you a combo guard. One, you can play the one and the two.
Wherever you put me at. If you want me at the four, I play the four. Wherever coach want to put me at.
And you can do just that.
I do just that. Wherever you want me to put. If it's helping us win, I'm willing to do it.
And that's what people don't understand. It's all about getting your foot wet. I just want to get on the floor. You play me, hey, I'm going to give you everything I have. If I had to put on some stilts to play the five, I go down and play
that's
the five.
What I'm going to do on the court. I'm happy.
So you be able to play there's no doubt that you can do whatever you put your mind to. It's proof in the pudding. It's here. They can't nobody say what he didn't do. You done everything you could. You left it all out here on the floor. Got a chance to see you stop, take pictures with people that you didn't even know, never see again. And how does that make you feel inside, where kids is like, hey, stop. Or like, they shooting a shot. That's Darrian Ford. You know, we said, I'm like Mike, and kids hollering, and they just like, man, I'm coming to see Darrian Ford tonight. How does that make you feel that a little kid get a chance to see you for the first time, like you said, and you get out here and perform and get a chance to take pictures with them?
It makes me happy, you know, seeing that I'm inspiration to somebody, because just like that kid happy to see me, I never want to be the type of person to say, I got to go right now. I want to try to take a picture of everybody. If it takes me all night to take a picture of everybody, I want to be that person, because just like I'm an inspiration to somebody, somebody inspiration to me. Like, Devin White came down here. That's a celebrity. I would want to take a picture with Devin. I'm now the shoes done changed. Now that person in my shoes and I'm that little kid. And so I would want Devin to take a picture with me. I would want to talk to Devin. I want to talk to that little kid, because I know if I was in his position, I would want somebody to talk to me, not just try to look me off or say they don't have time to talk to me. So you just always got to think about, what if I was in this position?
And then that's just like you said, you know, you watching others as you grow to make sure you stay on it. And Devin White, he was here one night and he stood there and took pictures with everybody. And he just had won a Super Bowl.
You couldn't tell if he won a Super Bowl or not, the way he talked to people. He don't change. He's down in Louisiana right now. And he's humble as all get out. But when he step on that field, he's a different person. But like you said, it's two different people.
I've watched him in action. He's a man above. And you know, I got a chance to talk with him, not taking the spotlight off you. And he was like, man, I got a helmet I need you to sign. He said, nothing. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm like, what? And some guys, I'm like, man, you don't get out of my face. And this some guys are from my hometown. And I don't care if they see this or not. It's guys that grew up in the projects with me. Man, they wouldn't even give you a pair of socks with their symbol on it. You know, and but guess what? They on the same level I'm on now. You know, one thing about God, you know, he'll get you there. But you can't forget about him. Hey. Because at the end of the day, if you forget about it,
he'll bring you down
so low. And that's the thing about it. Always stay humble in everything you do. Great career. And I'm telling you, awesome career, I tell you. I was like, man, you made me feel like I can play basketball sometime with you on the floor on the same team.
Oh, on the same
team. Yeah. You will take, you know, they'll double team you, so I'll be the man they win host, so I'll be able to just sit out here and shoot the basketball.
I'm
going
to give it to you.
You're going to give it to me? Hey, that's one thing about it. Got a little something for you. We're going to take a break. Got a little game for you when we come back.
Hey, young world, the world is yours.
Welcome back to today's episode. We got my guy Darrian Ford, the Razorback signee. Say you like basketball. I was going to go Wilt Chamberlain with you way back. And I said, no, you know, I know he know the game, but I don't know if he know it like that. Because I wouldn't even know it. I had to research as well. Got some, I'm going to shoot a name to you. In one or two words, just describe this person. Right. Magic Johnson.
Flashy. Winning mentality.
LeBron James.
Score, whatever you want him to do.
Stephen Curry.
Shooter, flashy.
Allen Iverson.
Aggressive. Score.
Michael Jordan.
A dog. Killer.
Kobe Bryant.
A dog and a killer.
Derrian Ford.
One of a kind.
Darnell Ford.
Legendary.
That's what you're legendary.
To me.
How big is that?
He big to me. I always wish I could get in a time machine. But like, he wouldn't know that he was my dad. But like, I could be a high school with him. And then I just go watch him play. We could just see what it was like. Like, I want to see what he was doing. Not everything, I just want to see what, like, basketball.
Yeah. So that's been a big plus. Your dad been a big inspiration in you. From the weight room to just standing here on the floor watching you. You know, standing here on the court, never say a word, just sitting there smiling. Just the guy that you want to talk to, mentor, you know, keep you on the straight and narrow, the defender, bodyguard, everything. You know, and so you, after a while, you have to have those. After a while, he'll be your agent. And so it's been a big plus to be able to say that, to get in here, to say those positive things. I asked you those for a reason. You line up with those guys at your level, coming out here. You know, if you know, a lot of people don't look on down south how great you really are. You know, I think 2 years in college, maybe unless you go stay there the whole 4 years, 2 years you gone. You have that mentality, you have that kind of game plan. And the guys that you'll get a chance to play with, man, y'all gonna be, I hate to say it, you might almost flip me over to the Razorback during basketball. Might. But I tell you, continue doing what you're doing. All the naysayers gonna be there. Success, it comes with that. Greatness, it comes with that. So you gotta, you know, I know you've been taught well to distinguish, hey, everybody ain't in your corner. The end of the day, you going off to college, total different environment. And we know what the hill creates with some guys. We know you gonna stay biblical, right there in the brim with God. Give God his time. And that's something I know you're going to bring to the table to Razorback basketball. They see success. It's something missing why they can't get past the Elite Eight. And it ain't just players. It's something missing. And I believe you got that missing piece that's going to bring them through to the championship, if not championships.
I pray so. I'll be working. Whatever the coach wants.
So I see you got that shirt on, say that work. What is that work all about?
You know, it was a family brand. You know, we always putting in work. My dad started it, and then it just became around the community thing. It's out in California now. Some people in California know about it. But, you know, just posting it on social media. And the three just represents one God, one faith, one baptism. Because, you know, we always got to keep God in whatever we do. And then big old basketball, you know, that's what we do every day in our life.
And at the end of the day, from the beginning, from your Texas journey to this journey, it was all God's plan.
All God's plan.
I want to thank you for today's episode of Inside High School Sports.